Now there is no honey in it. It's the grape itself. It's gonna make you smell like a mead wine. That sweet might taste a little sweet in the beginning, but then you're gonna notice it gets cleaner, crisper, a little sharper, like a Pinot Grigio or a Chardonnay style. Now if you go more north, this becomes like more like a honeydew melon in sweetness. If you go more south, it's gonna be a little more lemony, a little more citrus too. It's the grape where it's growing.
Good friends, hopefully, for a long time.
A little fruity in the beginning, but then you're going to notice it has more of a cranberry tart. No cranberries in it. It's just what we're going to pick up.
Okay.
This is also the main ingredient in our sangria. You want me to go slow because you're filming?
Sure. Yeah. Thank you.
Uh-oh.
That's all I get? No. Not fair.
You should get a bonus.
I think so, right? Pastrami.
I should have bought more than you.
Please sign our grape to grow. We do grow some here that we know of. We're the only vineyard from here to Virginia that can grow.
But I'm curious. I thought Zinfandel was white. Like, what's going
there
on
here? There is white Zinfandels, and then there's also red. It's like a rosé is white and red.
I'm
sitting
on the grass.
You're from St. Lucia and you're hitting me. I'm sitting on the grass.
There you go.
You will see the grapes, see how little they are. They're almost like, there's a nice bundle right there. Almost like the fake grapes that you have. They're not ready. Another month maybe they'll be a little more bigger, a little more sweeter for us. And starting in August, he starts to test them. He'll test the sugar levels for them, the yeast letter, the yeast on them, just to make sure that they're ready for us to pick. And like I said, we do need that snow. That snow helps us insulate these roots to protect them from the elements. Rain is a balance. We're one of the luckier vineyards here. You know, there's 46 vineyards in Connecticut now. We're one of the luckiest because we do have the rocky terrain, so everything is good drainage up there. But those vineyards that are pretty much low-lying, they're drowning in the water. It's not good for the roots. And then again, you need the sun. We do have the ocean breezes. So we're one of those vineyards that don't need to spray as much as the other vineyards. So we spray twice a year, and we use things. We're very close to organic. We can't call ourselves organic. And we can't call ourselves vegan because of the animal life that lives here. We do have sheep and goats. We have the birds. We have, other creatures. So they won't let us do that. But the stuff we spray is stuff that we use in our own yards.
What is the lifespan for a grape tree?
Well, the vines itself, the more hardy of those vines, if you can stay, the older the vine, the better the wine.
How
and the better
years?
The grape. So we have three varieties that are now 20 years old, some of those vines, and growing.
In general, how many?
Usually, in New England, they'll maybe make to 25, 30 tops because the climate's so bad. You know, either the storms will come and take them, you know, hurricanes or too much rain or bad winters or things like that usually. I think there's only a few of us that'll have vines that are more than 20 years old.
And did you say that you seal them, you cover?
We don't cover anything with the vines. The babies we do. If we go and plant something in the spring, winter time comes, we will plant them. You'll see almost like little blue tubes. If you see new blue tubes on any of the vines in any of the vineyards, you know those are the young ones. They're those ones that are protecting. We want them to come up. We're protecting them from the insects, the bugs, and from the weather conditions.
Do you need to use pesticides?
We just spray once. We spray twice. Once in the beginning and once after. Unless, like, with all the rain, I am thinking they're going to have to get back out with their spray again because that's what causes the diseases. But we're very close to the ocean.
down here. This is our new expansion. So that's right above this deck. As you can see, we've already filled it. So we haven't been able to utilize this except for storage right now. And they've already started bottling, capping some of the stuff for what's already in these tanks. So what happens here is when we have our pick, our harvest, we bring in volunteers. We'll bring in about 300 volunteers because we're one of the vineyards that like to do everything by hand. Some of them are using a lot of machinery. So we'll bring in the 300 volunteers. We put out a list the end of August, beginning of September. And first 300 answer. Portuguese community come from all starch fermentation. We need to lower the temperature for at least 36 hours, sometimes up to 48. And what happens is you'll literally see ice on this. So that starts everything. And then we'll start racking. Rack is at the tops of them will start popping. So all the extra skins and everything will come. We'll start racking from underneath, bringing all the junk that is settling that we don't want. A lot of people don't understand with reds. The darker the red means the skin stayed on longer. And that's what you get that tannins, that point for the reds. It's the skins that do that. So when you have those whites that have that little bit of cling to it or that drier white, that's usually from the skins. With the reds, it's the opposite. When we pick the reds, we will raise the temperature up and they'll stay in the tanks for 72 hours. Because we really need to have those really fermented a little bit longer. So then we're going to, after we have that all going, we decide what we're going to do. Now all our whites are acting more in testing and also filtering. Filtering purifies it. It's going to get all those, if we don't want too many tannins, if we want it on the lighter side. This machine here is like an accordion. Stretches out and has a whole lot of filters in it. So we'll run it through the filter a few times and put it back either in the tank or get ready to bottle it. On the day of, am I going too fast?
The barrels are one time use? Or?
No, we use our barrels 4 to 6 years. And then he wants to get rid of them. He will not use new barrels. They've got to be at least a year, 2 years old. Reason being because they'll be too oaky, we're too smoky, we're too woody tasting to it. But for his safety, he likes to get rid of them after 6 years. He won't mess with them. And they just get too worn, whatever you're putting in them. So they lose their body to it. On the day of the bottling, what we'll do is we'll filter it. That's also a filter. It'll come through. So we'll either have a hose hooked up to the barrel of the tank. It'll run through here. It'll run through this filter. Okay. We will have 3 people down here on that day. I'm sorry if it's the ladies, we go faster. This machine, as it's coming through the last filtration, wine is coming in here. This is circulating, and this will fill our bottles. So it'll go around. So one is going to be bottling. Then this is our cork machine. Somebody will be corking. Somebody will be casing. On a good day, the guys can do maybe 900 bottles in an hour.
Wow.
In an hour. That's not a lot. The girls, if we all had a glass of wine, it's about 1,200 bottles an hour. And we will have them labeled. We do the labeling. We have a machine for labeling, but we like to label ourselves. We're used to it. He likes the old world, including with the cork. We use real cork. He's tried synthetic. He does not like it. You know, when you get a bunch of women drinking wine and they're dead, time goes by faster. I don't know. It just works. This is the cork. A lot of people are really going to synthetic. If you look, this is the stump. That's what's done. They just literally take the cork off and punch a hole. The wine is by that door. That is going to change the temperature of the wine. So you will pick 2 molecules, will separate, and it'll cause that crystallization. Nothing to worry about that. That is a natural thing that happens. You can add stuff to the wine that stops that. There's only maybe once that he did that we had a really bad season, and we kept seeing that happening. So he added a little bit. Otherwise, he likes to leave it natural. That's why he'll tell people, you can take our wine home, store it right. You don't want it sitting on a wine shelf. because your air condition's going up, your heat's going up, your air condition, it's going to change your wine. People got to, but they don't know that. But yeah, very seldom. He likes to keep it as natural as possible.
So when people say the year of the wine could tell the character, it's actually true. Like
yes.
No brand of wine is the same 2020, 2019.
Yes, it's absolutely true.
Because every year depends on what you get.
It depends on the season, too.
It's like two different wines.
Yeah, because what if we had a real, real long hot summer this year? Like 2014, 15, and 16 were excellent for reds. Long hot summer. And those, when they say 16, that's the year you pick them. They were long, hot, dry. We had the proper snow. We had the proper rain. Perfect reds came out of them. This year it's going to be light, but we're not going to have a lot of juice in the summers. So yeah, it does.